digging in the crates for something, yeah. Hidden gems often misunderstood. Cause you know there's no such thing as too much. Miscellaneous important stuff.
Welcome back to the show. This week, my friend Carly was here. And we talked about having kids. Not her and I having kids, but just the idea of having kids and what that can mean for one's life, some of the fears and concerns that come with that. And we talked about where she's at with that decision in her own life right now. It was an interesting conversation. It was a lot of fun. I hope you guys enjoy it too. Here it is. Carly.
Hello, Jay.
Hello.
Hey, thanks for having me here.
Yeah, thanks for...
I'm really excited to be here.
Me too.
And your space is so cool.
Yeah, you know, I keep saying it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to do video eventually.
Okay.
Because I think we do talk about the space a lot on here. Or
oh,
I
really?
Do with other people. I like this space. It's got a lot of things. I got Legos in front of you that nobody can see. But
yep.
One day, I'm going to do a live stream... It's just That's a lot. Good. It's been okay. A lot just to figure out like how to work everything I have already. So.
Yeah, I always say like set your goals because if you continuously dwell on what you want to do, you'll never do them.
That's so true.
So it's great to have aspirations and dreams.
You're saying I should write it down?
Yeah, maybe. Give yourself a timeline and then just do it one day.
That's usually how I think about things a lot. And then I just one day I'm like, all right, today's the day.
Yeah, that's how I feel. All the time.
Is that how it's gonna go for you with kids?
Oh, probably not. I think that if I have the opportunity to be able to plan for something like that, I will definitely not be it's time, you know, one of those things.
Yeah. Well, that would be hard.
Yeah.
I think the same thing. I don't know.
Yeah. Which I guess brings us into our conversation for this.
So... Tell me how old you are first of all.
I am 22. I am graduating college this summer with a BA in advertising. I am looking to pursue a pre-med program. I'm not sure where, but we'll be at a state school because that's what my scholarship is through. So I'm really excited.
Yeah.
Yeah. I started out college wanting to be a pre-med major, and I did that for 1 year. So I actually have a biology minor, which is kind of funny. And I ran into like a weird professor who talked me out of it, of staying in, because like we were doing like a weird like 5-year plan talking about insurance or something. Like some of those like weird like foundation classes, you know? And he was like, well, the U.S. is going to be socialized and
that's all it took.
Doctors won't make any money and you should just go do what your heart wants to do, which I like, I don't know. I guess at the time I was working for a department where I was doing graphic design and I was like pretty good at it, I would say. And I pursued that for a little bit. And so I was like, you know, this is a lot easier. It truly is. It came naturally to me than studying genetics at 3 a.m. And so I figured that if I could graduate in 4 years and get a degree that I would like and not have to worry about medical school, because at the time I didn't know if I was going to be able to pay for it, but now like I can, I just switched. But like ever since then, I've always like had this lingering, I won't say dread, but like want to know if I were to go back and do it, how I would do.
Yeah.
So yeah, we'll see. I mean, I think that life is so short that like if you're not doing something that you know want to take a chance at and you have the ability to, like you should.
Just see
what
happens.
If you're not doing that, then like what's the point?
Yeah.
Yeah, so my ultimate goal is to be a pediatrician.
Huh.
Yeah.
That's good.
Yeah.
And you're in a long-term relationship, right?
I am. I've been dating my boyfriend going on 3 years now. It feels like forever though. I've been
in a good way or a bad way?
Would you say in a good way?
He said it feels like
it feels like in a good way. It feels like like, since I've been to long-term relationships, one that was 3 years, one was two. It's like sounds so short since I've been, you know, going longer, I guess, and other.
No, that sounds like forever to me.
It does. Yeah, but then
I've never been.
But then maybe you talk to like old people or something. Not old people, but people who've been married for like 20 years or whatever. More than that, they're like, oh, 2 years, you still got time to make sure it's the right one.
Oh, I think if you get past a year with somebody, doing pretty good.
Yeah, we've been living together for, almost two years now. Yeah. So it was more financially smart. We were hanging out with each other all the time anyways. So it was like, why are we paying an extra $1,000 a month if we're always with each other?
Yeah.
And so we just kind of made that leap, and it's been really, really good and really nice. And
So looking forward, what if I don't know your boyfriend. Yeah. I don't know what's going on with you, but let's just say you got married.
Okay. We got married. Bam. Shabam.
No kids.
No kids. Yeah. So I do not want to have children of my own. And that's comes from a number of reasons. Not because I don't like children. I love children. I want to dedicate my life to helping children and helping mothers help their own children. And in a sense, like save lives of young children. I've been a babysitter since I was 16. I'm constantly babysitting someone's kids on and off, you know. But I would love to adopt. I love to adopt. Like, there's no part of me that says I don't want to have kids of my own, but the fact of giving birth is horrifying to me.
Is that the only thing, though? Like, is that what would stop you
honestly,
from having kids?
Honestly, yes. Like, I think that the financial side of it, I could be able to get through. I feel like, you know, if my partner and I did end up staying together and I wasn't stuck as a single mom, it would be a lot more hopeful, you know? My mom raised my sister and I as a single mom until we were I was five and my sister was three. And like horror stories from that is insane. But the reason why I don't want to have kids of my own is because, well, I'll go back a little bit to a research project I had to do last semester.
Okay.
So I'm an advertising major, as I said, and one of the big classes we have to take, I think everybody does, I'm not sure, but the school I had to take is a research class. And so we have to write a like 50 page background research paper and then like almost 150 page paper on the research project that we do. And so I decided, so I actually have a small business. I make baby hats, which is kind of funny. I did it mainly because I liked making things with my hands and it was easy, simple, fast. And I like shipping and packaging things. So it honestly just like turned all my little likes into one little thing. But part of that, I have customers from all over the US and a lot in Canada. I actually just sent out 3 packages to Canada today, which is kind of funny.
Okay.
Because they actually have to pay for their own shipping for Canada. I do for shipping in the US, but Canada shipping's like really expensive, which is
From here.
Yeah, like $13 for a package that's like 5 ounces. I'm like, oh my gosh, it's insane. But anyways, so I had to say this, lots of customers across the US, and I was like, you know what? A great opportunity I have to interview these people who are mothers, because I make baby hats, right? And who are probably they probably do have the answers that I'm seeking, right? So my research project was behind the scenes of how Instagram use affected young mothers with kids ages 10 and younger. And it turned out that I only interviewed one person who had a child over the age of 5. So mainly they were newborns or less than 3, a lot of them were. And so some of the questions I asked was like, so you see a lot of posts about other moms and you have this idealized version. Like, how does that reflect real life? That was one question I asked. I asked, like, do you have an obligation to post happy things versus sad things? Like real life things, not sad things, excuse me. I also asked them, like, if you could change the way that you perceive yourself on social media, specifically Instagram, like, what would you change? And then I also asked them, if you could look at your profile and it wasn't you, like if it was like somebody else looking at it, like what would you say to this person's profile, which is actually your profile, you know, like kind of stepping out of your own skin. And we got in these crazy conversations about motherhood that I had no idea about. Like, seriously, I have taken so many biology classes, so many, I've babysat for so many mothers. I've been friends with mothers. I've seen so many posts. I've had this business and I read so many posts that people do post. And then all this like hard, soul crushing, depressing things that came from such a like lighthearted place.
Like what? I mean, give me the worst example.
So worst example was a mom who had a 3-month-old, and we were doing an interview, and she's from a well-off family. I won't say her name or anything. She's from a well-off family, so all the support financially she would ever need. So if she needs help, she can go get help. She needs medicine, whatever. Like, there's no fear, but she never bonded with her child. Because her child was in the NICU or something for a few days, or something happened where I don't know exactly what the deal was. I did not push into that because it was getting really emotional of a conversation at the time. But she like was just opened up to me, and she was crying. And I actually started crying because I just felt so bad for her. And she was like, I don't think I'll ever be able to have this connection to this child. And like, I've gone to therapy for it, and of course it's only been 3 months, but like even her therapist said, like, you need more help than what I can give you. Like, she had evil thoughts about this kid, and like totally from the place that it's like doesn't make any sense. Like, she has everything that she could ever ask for help. It's not like she's like, it's like ruining her life or anything, but she's seriously, it's like this detached thing that she gave birth to that she cannot be connected with. And that was like so hard to hear, you know? And that's something I never thought was possible. I was like, oh, like even if like it was a, you know, a change of pace in your life, of course, and you have this like thing that, you know, needs you constantly and doesn't understand, you can't communicate with it. Like, would it really be to the point where you like you hate it? You know, I don't know. I just never thought about that.
I think that's something you can't have an answer to, though.
Yeah, and then like I remember I reached out to her recently. I did that. So my research project was finished in January, and I reached out to her recently, and her baby's now like 8 months old or something, and she had the same feelings. Oh, she said she was getting more mental health, and they were doing hormone testing on her to make sure that it wasn't like something like totally got out of whack, and her body was like making up for something, like overcompensating. It's like it's all neurological, like completely. Like, she always had wanted to be a mother, and that was like what hurt her heart the most, is that like she couldn't be the mother she thought she could be or thought it was.
Yeah, I also wonder if some people aren't as ready to be parents as they think they are, or they want so badly to be a parent that desire blinds them. They don't even see that they probably shouldn't be having a kid yet.
Yeah.
You know, because people have kids young, which is, I guess that's fine, but then I don't even think you've learned who you are yet. I'm 32 now. I don't know that I'm ready to have a kid. Well, I'm definitely not. I'm not even, with anybody that I could have a kid with. So, I mean, there's just so many things that you can't know about having kids. I don't have kids, but I know that's true.
Oh, yeah. And of course, like, I'm speaking from only a perception of these people who I've talked to and taking in how I would, you know, what if that happened to me?
Yeah.
And like, giving like, I guess, an opinion about the situation. So of course, if I had a child of my own, it might be a totally different story, and I might, you know, have a totally different answer, but I don't think that I will be in that position.
Even if you adopt, though, I mean, I have a friend I used to work with. Him and his wife adopted when they were like 40, these newborn babies. And they grew up to have so many different problems that they couldn't have known about, and it's just been a huge stress on his life. He loves those kids, and you do anything for them, but
it's hard.
Man, are they're a handful.
Yeah,
they're adults now, but every time I see him, like, how are things going, he's like, these kids,
they're tearing us apart.
Yeah, but he loves them. It's so, just like,
so I babysat for a family when I didn't live in the state, and they were adopting a child. They didn't know what age, and so they were on a waiting list, and it turned out to be an 8-year-old boy, and he came from like a whole different culture, and his mom was like on drugs or something, and it was like her last strike or something. Like, basically he couldn't go back, so like this was gonna be his permanent home. And yeah, they end up getting a divorce. They already had two children before that, and so this was their third. They had so many arguments about it. Like, it progressed. Like, the mom had to quit her job to take care of the 8-year-old boy who was like having these temper tantrums at school, who like could not control his anger and was hurting the other kids. And like, they didn't know what to do. They had no idea, because you can't call the police on an 8-year-old, right? And yeah, they would sometimes. He would throw temper tantrums that bad that the mom would, you know, be like actually fearful of, you know, her life. And the husband or the dad couldn't do anything because he's an 8-year-old boy. He can't beat them, you know? But at the same time, like, you have a kid coming at you with a knife, a butcher knife from the kitchen, threatening your other two kids. It's like, what do you do? And he didn't have any type of psychological problems at all before that. Now he's fine now. He's in high school. Okay. And he's doing great. He's an honor society. They've posted about how much, you know, progress he's gotten. He's on the football team. Like, he's definitely, like, controlled himself. But, like, getting to that point, like, they're still divorced and probably not going to get back together. But, like, that could happen too, you know?
Sure. So I guess, why do you feel more comfortable about the idea of adopting than you do having your own kids?
I don't know if it comes from my fear of my own psychological being changed and not having control over that, or like some people who give birth have contractions up to like a month afterwards, and living with that pain, I don't know if I could do, or even giving birth. Like, it's there, women are so strong, and like, I've had brain surgery, you know what I mean? And I've gone through the worst of the worst pain that I could ever have. I used to remember being in high school and people would be like, this pain that you're feeling is nothing like giving birth. Like, you'll be fine if you ever give birth. Like, you've already gone through the worst, you know? And maybe it does stem from that, but I don't know. I just don't think that, like, I do not feel called, and I have no desire to have my own children. I don't want to. I have this like such innate like feeling of like helping, I guess, than like wanting to create my own, which I have no opinion about that, you know?
Yeah.
Like, do what you want. Like,
sure.
If that's what you want to do, then do it. But I don't, you know?
But do you think that'll change?
I don't know.
Like 10 years from now.
Well, my boyfriend and I have talked about it. I think that like, I used to have an idealized idea of like all of that, but I don't know. I feel so much more content and like, I don't know, like happy thinking that like I wouldn't have to go through that, I guess.
But you did before, like you.
But yeah, I did before because I didn't really understand. I was like, yeah, I'm a woman, right? And I'm gonna find somebody I love, and we're gonna have a baby, and it's gonna be great and beautiful, and we're gonna be strong, and I'll be strong. But then I like got to interview these amazing women whose hearts are broken for the situations and experiences that they've gone through giving birth. Like, one lady told me a horror story about the doctor like feeling her up while putting an epidural in her back. Like, stuff like that. I mean, that could happen anytime, but
sure,
like,
not just
stuff
just
like, yeah, not just that, but like stuff like that. And you don't like, or you know, how medicine has changed over the last couple of years, and how like if you give birth in the hospital and what they can give you and not give you, and like if you're insured versus not insured, how they treat you differently, and then just like all that stuff. Like, that's a whole other like stupid side of capitalism things, but I don't know. That's a whole other thing. That could be for any hospital visit, but
that's true.
Yeah, I don't know.
You haven't totally narrowed it down yet?
I don't think it's that. I just think that I haven't given myself a reason as to why I don't want to have my own children. And I've kind of just accepted that I don't.
That's just the way you feel, but you don't necessarily have like, this is the
Yeah, like thing. If it ended up happening, like, you know, I wouldn't be like the horrified, you know? But
yeah,
if I have a choice and I'm able to, like I said in the beginning, like able to have that plan, and I'll be able to control, if I have the ability to control that, then it will not be my choice. Like at a, you know, fresh, clear mind with, you know, I actually have the power, you know?
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean,
I think about that a lot. I mean, I don't know.
Yeah.
I think I would enjoy being a dad.
Mm-hmm.
But then I don't want kids so badly that I'm willing to just find somebody to have kids with, I guess.
Oh, yeah. No, yeah, I definitely. Like, I used to remember, like, you know, playing MASH and, like, middle school or whatever, like date, marry,
yeah,
having a baby, or like, what is it, like smash pass and something, whatever,
the paper,
yeah,
games.
That paper thing where you like write a bunch of names down. I forgot, yeah, what it's called, but I used to remember like, yeah, I'll have like a little family. I couldn't imagine having more than one child, even if I had, you know, even if I had my own.
No.
Yeah,
I think we're all just built different. Some people want 10 yeah. children and they're like, this is great, I love it.
Yeah,
it's insane. I wouldn't want that.
I don't know. I just think that is remarkable. And like, I have like no judgment on that. But at the same time, it's like, I feel as though I have like dedicated my life to like this career that I'm trying to pursue. And I felt so like happy about it for like a good year now. Like the first time in my whole life, like actually being like, yeah, I'm going to do this, you know, and I'm going to be really happy.
Did you have a moment?
I did have a moment.
Thing changed? What was it?
I did have a moment. So, when I moved here, so I've only been here for 2 years. So, I did half my schooling in a different state. I was looking at all my transcript stuff and seeing what I could, you know, transfer. And when my degree would be over with. I was supposed to graduate this May, but my credits didn't pass through correctly or something weird. I don't know. It could be because I went pre-med my first year. I don't know. But I looked at them all, and I, you know, I'm going back all the way from freshman year, and I'm asking myself, these are interesting decisions that I made. Why did I take this class? Like, why did I want to do this? And I'm thinking to myself, like, how did I get here? Like, why am I going to Oklahoma City? Like, why am I going to the school? Like, where am I going next? And I was kind of like, why did you switch? I wasn't mad at myself about it. I was just like, why did you switch? Like, that was your dream. Like, you were president of a health club. You started a chapter in Missouri. Like, you got to go to Disney World for free because of this. You won this huge scholarship. I am debt free because of my medical love in high school. And yet I changed my degree because of one person who was crazy and got fired later on. That's the whole story.
Well, maybe he just pointed it out. Maybe he just made you, yeah, realize that you didn't want to do it. Maybe.
I don't know. And then I kind of thought about it too for a long time. Like, if I ended up being graduating, right, with a 4-year Bachelor of Science in Biology or whatever, pre-med, and I don't go to medical school, like, where I take an MCAT, let's say, right, and I fail it. Let's just say I failed the MCAT because I was, you know.
Let's say it.
Let's just do it.
Say it out loud.
I fail the MCAT, right? Then what's my next step? So I have a 4-year pre-med degree and I cannot be a teacher because I have to have a master's degree to do that. Unless I want to be a, you know, teacher in elementary school or middle school, some high schools. I can be a nurse, but there are so many nurse programs that are incredible through community colleges and nursing programs that will pay for you to go to nursing school.
Because they always need nurses, right?
Exactly. And so then I could be a researcher. I could help draw blood. These are all options that I don't need a 4-year degree for. And so I sat, that was another part of my changing a major. I was like, what is something that I need a major, like I need this degree for that I can get done in 4 years and it actually be worth my time? Because going to school for pre-med and not going to medical school is worthless. It really is, because there's so many other options that you can not be in debt and also get paid to do.
I guess the worst part. I didn't go to a 4-year college and I'm glad because I don't have any school debt.
Yeah, that's amazing.
Just paid as I went. I also don't think I needed a,
yeah, exactly,
4-year degree for what I'm doing.
Yeah, that's why, like, so my boyfriend, he's an artist and like we've had a lot of heart to hearts because he's in the Air Force too. I've had a lot of heart to hearts of him going to school, and I always question him. And we've probably had like a good heart to heart 3 times in this whole, like, good, solid, like, into the night conversation. We had one last night, actually. And I always ask him, like, what do you want to go to school for? And he can never tell me what for. It used to be architecture. I'm like, well, So that's 4 years plus 2 years, plus you have to fight to get to the top because it's a hugely saturated, you know, department. He's a beautiful artist, right? It's like, so you want to go to school for art, but why? For what? You can take classes.
You can learn a lot from, I feel like, if, yeah, maybe taking classes is the thing, though, even if you didn't get a degree.
I don't know. Like, I think that he can take classes, you know, like, with private instructors and get an experience with people who are at his same school level. Because a lot of times you go to art school or some other school, especially a state school, and it's people who are not on your skill level. For real. He's, like, world class. Like, he's amazing. He also does all his painting in oil paint, which is also insane. And he has the time skill and, like, eye, and it blows my mind.
Does he want to have kids?
No. Yes. And it was almost kind of funny whenever we first started talking about this, like, a long-term future, and I kind of, like, talking about marriage and all that kind of stuff, you know? Like, are we going to get married? You know, one of those things. He's like, oh my gosh, I'm so glad you don't want to have kids. I also do not want to have kids. And he is the tender-hearted, sweetest man you would ever meet. Like, somebody you never come across as not being a father. Like, he totally is, like, a father type of feeling guy, I feel like. But yeah, he was, like, so honest, like, relieved that I said that. But then again, like, we're so young that it could change.
Like, I hope it stays that way. But I think the worst case scenario is one of you says, I don't know, I want him now.
Yeah,
because I think that's common.
Yeah, but it's kind of like decorating a house and deciding to put something up on the wall whenever your partner doesn't even know about it, right? And you said before you weren't going to put that thing on the wall. That has to be a conversation for both parties. Yeah. I think definitely 100%. Like, and I'm not judging people who do this, but people who, like, make that ultimatum, like, we are 40 or whatever, let's have a child. Like, this is it. Like, we are going to not be able to, you know? And that's, like, it. And it can tear up relationships or make that person feel like they're not, like, welcome to voice their own opinion and stuff. So I think that if you set those boundaries early and consistently talk about them too, like, if it does change your mind, or if you do change your mind, like, talk about that. But, like, just to, like, make that, like, oh, I want to have kids. Like, we are going to have kids or else. Like, we're done. You know, that's so silly to me.
I know, that's tough. I mean, if you really want them, though.
Then yeah, that's silly? True. I mean, I don't know. Then I think that you're not respecting the person that you vowed to live your life with.
Yeah, but we're still, I feel like even if two people were together, you're still should still be individuals.
And oh, I think so.
If you're like, yeah. I want kids and I realize this is the only thing I want. And
well, then that person might love you enough to be like, you know, like, let's talk about it and, like, help me have my mind be persuaded, you know, and talk about those benefits and, like, carrying on the family name and having the DNA line continue, you know, all those fun things. And, you know, having the sense of purpose past your own life. There's a lot of great things.
Oh, sounds like you're talking yourself into it right now.
Right? Oh, yeah. I mean, that would be my reasoning into having a child.
Okay.
Well, besides, like, you know, wanting to have this, like, joy that I would not have otherwise. Which I kind of get already from babysitting and, you know, being able to talk to the mothers that I am graciously able to over Instagram and the internet and emails.
Yeah.
I get people all the time. I post like all this like dumb inspirational stuff on my story on my business page because I get so much interaction and not for sales. I don't have any spike in sales when I do this. It's mainly for interaction and trying to build this trust and saying like, although you're on the opposite side of the country, living in Tennessee or whatever, like, I am with you. I'm not a mother myself, but I love you. You are important. Whatever's going on in your life, like, I want you to know that, like, you have a voice.
You know? So tell me another sad story.
One of these interactions.
What are some of the sad, you know, mothers that you've
talked okay to. So social media, as you know, is like so fake in some ways, but then there's like this whole other side of social media that's like so real, and people like use that as a platform, and then you get into like this weird territory like do you post everything or do you post like whatever you want, you know, or do you post only the happy things, right? I think those are really the three things: happy things, like the most like raw, or like just whatever you want, and there's no cohesiveness or whatever.
I'd say bigger percentage is just the happy things, though.
Yeah, right? And so whenever one of the main questions which rounded out my research project was, I think I mentioned, like, how has your, you know, perception of social media changed after being a mother, after you've seen all of these, like, beautiful, like, mother, like, nursing images, and you see these nurseries and these beautiful white homes with these, like, babies smiling and eating their chopped peas, and mom and dad are holding each other in the background, blurred out or something, you know? Like, you have these, like, idyllic pictures in your head, right? Yeah. And then you get home from the hospital and you're bleeding and you are stretched out and you are exhausted and your partner really can't provide, you know, all of the care in a sense that, you know, a mother can. It's different. It truly is a different wall. There are a lot of single fathers that end up in situations like that, and that's a whole other story. But then you are left to, you know, have this huge responsibility. And, like, where's your white walls and your partner snuggling behind each other? Like, where's that at? And where is, you know, your child's throwing food? Like, where is the happiness in that, you know?
So that's, like, but that's like, people do that with everything, not just babies, just with relationships.
Yeah, and so one of the, you know, this one of the sad, I guess not sad stories, but one of the kind of good takeaways I had from one interview that I had, she was talking about, like, how pissed off she was that Instagram lied to her, that she, like, was alone because her partner had to go work and she only had one child, this infant, right? And so she was alone all day and nothing was happy. Not a single moment was happy because she was constantly either taking care of herself personally or trying to take care of this baby personally. And that there wasn't time for those pictures that are really cute and fun and adorable, right? Like, she didn't want to take a picture of herself. And she's like, I wish that, like, I don't, like, she didn't want, like, all the, like, honestly, and then you get, like, the raw side of it when then it turns too fake almost. Like, people are trying too hard to be, like, so raw and, like, real and emotional. And it's like, why can't we just post, like, what we want?
I feel like people should just take a break from social media altogether. I mean, yeah. It gives everyone the wrong idea.
Well, you know, like,
idea.
Social media is, like, there's, like, this, like, well, there, so there is a conspiracy, slightly. It was on Reddit a few years ago. I always find it, something like, on Tumblr, it'll show up. And it's, like, people still are commenting on it, although the post has been, like, grayed out or whatever that's called. But one of people are saying about that truly people are losing interest in social media because it's becoming more heavily advertised. And so people are taking to more things like blog posts and stuff, which is different. So it'll be interesting to see how it is adapted and changed. Because, like, as you know, like, Instagram recently put on their ads on their,
yeah.
Made that a part of their platform whenever Facebook bought them out.
Which I don't mind.
Mind that either. Yeah.
I just think people are on there looking to other people to make them happy, yeah. Or they're jealous of everybody else, or they're,
it is sad.
It's, we gotta stop assuming that something is gonna make you happy.
Yeah.
Nothing's gonna make you happy. Not always. I don't care if you find the right partner. I don't care if you have a kid or the right job. There's always things that go wrong. There's always people that die. Oh, there's always, you could get hurt. You're going to lose people.
Right.
And that won't stop until you die. So thinking that you're going to have a kid and then it's going to be beautiful. Of course, it is beautiful in some ways. It's going to be fulfilling in a deeper way.
Yeah.
It shouldn't be about the Instagram posts.
Right? Yeah.
Yeah. It's not about that at all. It's like I think, if you step away from social media and just live in that moment, it would be different. It's the expectations that are the problem.
Yeah, I get that. I think that's a great lesson. I think a lot of people miss is being content in the moment and where you're at and not stressing about how other people are going to think, but also not stressing about how other people are going to do things for you because, you know, you can only do so much for your own self. So,
I think it's just accepting sadness.
Yeah. And happiness.
Yeah, but being good with whatever, like riding the roller coaster.
Yeah.
And not expecting it to be better or worse than it is.
Yeah, just kind of take it, you know, take it for what it is, face value. And
some days are going to be great.
Yeah.
Some days aren't, but that's okay too.
I feel like that now sometimes. I used to have like this like goal I felt like that I needed to like have this perfect etched out future, right? So like that whole, you know, narrative I did with not knowing whether I was going to pay for medical school, right? I never gave myself a chance to even think about that.
Yeah.
I said, it's going to be really hard to do and I need to not, you know, push myself and not know. I will just change my major. And I thought this was going to make me happy and it didn't.
See, but there's a lesson in that too. Like you wouldn't have got that if you didn't say I just
I wouldn't have met people I met, right? If I didn't switch, I wouldn't have had the opportunities I've had. And the cool ass people I've met. I met some real cool people.
Yeah, the straight line going from A to B, that's boring anyway.
It is boring. I agree with that.
You'll get wherever you're going. It's just gonna be you're gonna be all over the place and that's better.
Yeah.
I never thought I would end up at an advertising agency, but I like it.
Yeah.
I've learned a lot. I've met some great friends.
Yeah.
But never saw myself doing what I'm doing now. Not exactly.
Yeah, I feel like I still have that open too. Like, I'm not like pre-med or nothing, you know?
Like, yeah.
I thought I was going to be staying in school until this fall, but I ended up getting the scholarship at a state school, any state school I really want to go to, which is really great. I was very, very lucky. So I had to give up this semester. So I'm graduating this summer.
Summer or December?
Summer. Yeah. So I was going to give this semester coming up, the fall, which I'm not doing anymore, a like chance to like see. So I was jumping into like second level classes that people had just taken. You know what I mean? So I was kind of like going to have to, you know, climb up the stairs and struggle to get up to knowledge, which I mean, I still retain a lot. I have lots of books to help me and the internet's great. But, you know, I would not be able to raise my hands to answer any questions. But I was not able to do that this semester, which is okay.
Yeah.
I'm happy with it because, you know, I can't change it right now.
Yeah, you did what you did.
Exactly. I did what I did and I'm not going to cry about it. I'm not going to post about it on social media either. You know, I never post about any of my surgeries ever on social media, ever. People, like, good. I remember leaving, and I'm never, ever posted about it. People are like, oh, my gosh, like, we thought you died. For real. So I also, like, I don't know, for some reason, I didn't have, like, my phone wasn't, like, cool enough to text people. So I never, like, talked to people on
my phone.
You
couldn't text? Like, it wouldn't text?
No, it was one of those, like, slider phones. But I think it was, like, a plan thing. Like, you couldn't text a lot of people.
It wasn't in the plan.
Yeah, it wasn't, like, in the plan. That's how mine was for a while. Like, the actual cellular plan. Yeah. Like, the data. But back whenever AT&T was Singular or whatever, I think.
Yeah.
I don't know. I didn't pay a bill like that. So I don't know if that's true or not. But, like, seriously, I never really talk about serious stuff. I think I'm more of on the side of, like, going with the flow and posting pretty things that I see.
See, that's all the good stuff.
Yeah. Like, I posted a picture of some pizza boxes in my passenger seat yesterday night. I'll show it to you. Well,
I saw that one.
Over there. Did you see it?
Is it on Facebook or Instagram?
It was on both. Yeah.
I saw it on one.
I typically only post on Instagram and just push it through Facebook because there's that option. Yeah, but, like, just did it.
So you don't ever post about bad stuff? Because maybe you're too unbalanced.
I have like a weight loss thing I've been like kind of pushing for, mainly because I've been using my own social media as like a yearbook. So it's not for anybody else but myself type of thing, which also is what this weight loss is too. You know, I got sick of complaining about it and I just freaking did it. It's
good
hard.
For you.
It's hard.
Of course it's hard.
It's freaking hard. And that's another thing. Like that idyllic thing, like join a gym. Like it'll be fun to make friends. Like, it's fucking hard.
Make it sound like fun.
It hurts. It freaking hurts. Like, running is not fun. Are you kidding? It is fun after a certain amount of
not
miles.
Not yet. I'm getting into running.
No. It's fun. But, like I got to get, like, through 4 miles for me to feel any type of fun. Like, getting up to that 4 mile.
It's terrible.
Fourth mile. Yeah. And it's like, okay. Like, what's that? Okay, we're going. We're still. Oh. We're only at 2.5. Okay.
The great part about doing anything like that, though, is when you're done, you feel like you did something.
Everything. Oh, yeah. Like, do we have enough time? Do we have enough time? Do we have a lot of time?
What's happening? What is that noise?
Oh, sounds like a phone of mine.
I have.
Probably a bill collector.
We have a minute and a half.
Okay.
Minute and a half.
Well, I don't know. Talk about. Is that going to pick up on your thing?
Probably.
I'm sorry.
For anybody who can't hear, Carly's phone is ringing.
Wait, yeah, it's is it a 918 area code, so it is probably like...
Tulsa.
Is right? it Tulsa?
Isn't 918 Tulsa?
Oh, I don't know. It's probably some like, pay your student loan. We have information about you or some stupid thing. I have 4 years to pay them, bruh.
Or like the fax I just got that said my dad was not alive and...
Yeah,
there's a life insurance.
That's like an identity theft thing.
Oh, I kind of want to call him though.
Maybe. I mean, you should. You should call your dad. Call your dad.
I want to call my dad and make sure he's alive.
Call your dad. Call your mom. This is a timely podcast for Mother's Day. If you don't have a mom,
I'm going to have my mom.
Call somebody that you know who is a mom or text them and say that you are proud of them and that you love them for being a mom, even if they're not your own mom. And just say that, you know, just want to let you know I appreciated you.
That's a great way to wrap it up.
There you go. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, thanks today. For coming on. I don't know if we, you know, discovered the answers to the world or anything like that.
I don't think
that,
we did, no.
But
it is a 22-year-old's opinion from a small background of taking care of children.
Hey, but it is an opinion.
It is, yeah.
You
know,
you combine your opinion with everyone else's
exactly.
And we bring them together and talk about them.
Yeah.
Stuff gets done.
It does, yeah. Yeah.
So there you go.
That's how the United States was made.
Was it?
Right? Because everybody was like hated Europe or Britain.
Yeah.
And they came over here.
Yeah.
They're like, yeah, I'm same boat, bruh.
Yeah. We took a turn like somewhere else, but that's fine.
We did. Okay, we're done.
That's fine. All right. Well, come on again soon.
Okay, bye.
Bye. I'm glad I got the chance to talk to Carly. Kids is a tough topic. It is for me, at least. I mean, it's, I think deciding to have kids or to not have kids, that's a tough decision in life. And it's always interesting to talk through it with somebody else. So thanks again to Carly for coming on. If you like this episode, please let me know. If you hated this episode, please let me know. And if you have any ideas for future episodes, please let me know. Thanks so much for listening. And I'll see you next week.